Rice Krispers!
We're making Rice Krispie treats for home teaching.
We gotta go home teaching today, and then we gotta make cookies.
You know what? We go home during Sunday school.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest. We have Sunday school just us two. We talk about things that are important.
Yeah, and we make cinnamon rolls and Rice Krispie treats.
Yeah.
We woke up a little late, so we missed breakfast.
So we come home to eat it.
So we come home to eat it.
Do you think that's good, or do you think it needs more Rice Krispies?
I think it's good. If anything, it needs more
marshmallows. See, we're opposite. I like when it's more...
Less gooey gooey.
Less gooey gooey. More crispy.
Like, unlike me, I'm more ooey gooey.
Have you guys tried this?
We got some coconut oil Pam spray. Should be good. Does it smell like cocoa nuts?
Uh-uh.
No?
But it's supposed to be healthier.
Supposed to be healthier. So we've been on a kick lately. And so we bought a whole bunch to try. And right now we're gonna try Ipanema pomegranate. And I don't know what happened. I was shaking it and the tag came off. But we're gonna try it.
Some of them taste like coffee.
Some of them, the bubble ones, the best bubble one we've found so far.
Coconut lime.
Is the coconut lime, hands down. And we tried...
I ended up buying like 10 of them.
We tried a coconut pineapple one. Sorry, I'm adjusting the tripod right
orange.
Now. We tried the blood orange. And we tried... It was... The worst one was the coconut
pineapple.
That
it
one...
It literally tastes... Before I even knew there was coffee in it, I was like, holy cow, you can taste...
That one really tastes like coffee. So let's try the Ipanema pomegranate. This one's bubble-free, because that's the way to be.
I like bubbles. Maybe it's not.
Bubbles have upset my stomach. Pretty good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty good. You can really taste the palm and the stevia. Got like a sweetener aftertaste, but they use stevia, not aspartame, because aspartame is nasty.
Let's just say Steven decided to go through all of his old files. Who has files? I don't know.
I got a whole file on my acting career.
Literally 5 million like folders from his parents. I barely have one picture of me as a child. Like, my family did not keep anything. First up, the and he has literally his middle school ID card.
I have a whole book report that I did.
So he's about to recite me something that he says I need to hear.
This? So I did a whole report apparently on the ABCs of Indiana, and every letter get something that Indiana has to offer. Like, E is for electric power. Most of the electricity that is generated comes from electrical plants that burn coal. Some comes from the hydroelectric plants and plants that burn petroleum or natural gas in Indiana. This says that Chloe and I were supposed to get married.
What?
Yeah. So, I don't know when I wrote this. I don't know when I wrote about the ABCs of Indiana, but I did it. And I just want you to know that P is for peony. It is the state flower. It flowers in late spring and gets up to 3 feet high. They grow in cool climate gardens in fertile soil and need protection from strong winds, and they need extra protection in warm climates. They make excellent cut flowers, and I spelled excellent wrong. But Chloe's favorite flower is the peony, and I did a report on Indiana whose state flower is the peony. Therefore, we were meant to be.
Totally. Hello.
It's my little
Messy.
My little messy domestic. The timer went off. The cookies are done.
We're making cookies.
My domestic goddess.
That's what I want to be called.
That's what she wants to be called. She's so good. Look at her cookies. These ones are just coming out. Oh.
Do you think they're good?
Yeah, they look good. They look good, and she made some frosting.
We're going to a potluck.
We're going to a dessert potluck tonight. And it's gonna be yummy. But she's done it all, and all I'm doing is putting together leftovers for dinner.
We have a ton of leftovers, and we decided to scrounge.
I'm a waste. You're messy.
I'm messy.
Look at Martha Stewart. Prissy got the problem with having a baby bump is it sticks out, so you get all the flour on it.
Yeah. What are you guys doing for Valentine's Day? Like, you make a big fuss about it? Do you just have like normal day? We're trying to decide.
I'm not a big Valentine's person because I think Valentine's Day is a Hallmark holiday, simply invented to sell cards, greeting cards, and chocolates.
I am a big Valentine's Day.
She's a big Valentine's Day person.
But not like so much like doing something. We don't need to go on like a date or anything, you know?
There's the lighting.
I don't feel like we need to go on a date. I just feel like it's important to recognize each other.
Yeah. I also don't agree with needing one. I mean, it's sweet and it's special, but I also don't agree with needing one day to like remind people to think of their significant others. For people like us, we think of each other every single day, but I think it's kind of not heartfelt when you're like, oh, it's Valentine's Day, so I have to give you this card.
Yeah.
But what do you guys do? What are your thoughts?
I think we'll keep it cash this year.
Yeah. We're talking about going out to have fondue. Could be good. Limit, though, $50.
To spend
on each other. And we'll let you know how it goes.
He didn't follow it last time.
She never follows the budget that we have for any holiday, so...
I follow it.
Never follows it. And when she doesn't, she blames it on Cruz.
The baby.
Oh,
shit, cookies. I forgot about it.
So... Happy Valentine's Day! This is my Valentine. She's got spots on her face because she's doing her makeup. We just woke up. I'm getting ready to go to work.
I love you.
I love you. But it's Valentine's Day.
We don't got any plans, but we're gonna spend it together. Well, not today.
Together at the gym.
We're going to Hawaii in a week and a half.
Yep. Gotta get bikini body ready.
They have those heart-shaped pizzas at Papa Murphy's.
Okay. I'm home from work to work on Valentine's Day. So, I am going to Chloe's work to surprise her for Valentine's Day. A couple months ago, she asked, we were talking about Valentine's and asked, what do you want for Valentine's Day? And she, being the modest person that she is, said she didn't want anything for Valentine's Day. All she wanted was kisses and... Sorry, I'm trying to adjust the camera. So she wanted kisses, like me to kiss her, not Hershey kisses. And she wanted me to dress up like Cupid. Obviously all just a joke, but over the last couple days, I've been collecting things to dress up like Cupid. And so now, I'm trying to get a white sheet to make a diaper. Because Cupid wears a diaper. Obviously. So, not to mention, I mean, I guess it's the things you do for love, right? Because who else and what else would lead you? To dress up like Cupid, a dumb holiday called Valentine's Day, I'm not gonna lie, I don't get embarrassed really easily, but it's gonna be slightly embarrassing and really funny walking through her office dressed as Cupid. Well, here we go. Not even ashamed. Even a little bit.
Hey, you're pretty willing, I know. Some people would do that.
And of course, the cheapest wings they had were the ones with glitter on them, so. Thank you. Got my wings on. Tuesday, so I think they have an executive meeting. You said the one thing you wanted for Valentine's Day was for me to dress up as Cupid.
Oh, I love you. Did you do Taco Bell too?
We had a whole conversation about Taco Bell.
Did you bring Taco
Happy
Bell?
Valentine's Day.
Yes, this is so cute. Where did you get this?
Well, I have your
my present.
Yeah.
Yours are at home.
I know. I figured as much.
Are you kidding me?
Half from me, half from Cruz, so.
This is way over our budget.
Well, Cruz chipped in. I love you.
I'm gonna cry. Can we turn that off?
You can edit it out.
No, we're good.
Those are the best moments.
Do you want